get ready to worship God. So even before we begin, can we all just move around and just say hi to like three new people? Can give them a high five, fist bump, whatever. Church in, I was just reading Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, and it talks about the seasons of life. It talks about there's a time for every purpose under heaven. You know, there's a time to laugh, there's a time to cry, there's a time for weeping, time of great joy, of great sorrow. And I'm sure we can all, you know, testify to that. You know, life is just like that. And but it's interesting, there's no season of worship. I was just reading through. It only tells me one thing, church, that we always worship, no matter what season we're in. It doesn't matter if we're in the lows of the lows or at the highest peak. No, let us resolve in our hearts to always lift Him up. Because, church, His grace was never seasonal. His mercy was never seasonal. His great love for us was never seasonal. So can we resolve that in our hearts, church? That we would always, no matter where we are, we'll always lift His name up. So if you have two hands, can you lift those two hands to heaven and just begin to just create an atmosphere of the praise? If you have one hand, can you lift that one hand? If you've got a voice, can you just shout praises to our King, for He is worthy.
Worthy, God, You're worthy.
As long as we have breath, can we resolve in our hearts? We'll always worship You, God. We thank You, God, that You are always faithful, God, even when we are not faithful. That You're always good, that You're always merciful, God. And tonight, God, and today, God, we choose to give our worship to You, God. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Praises to Your name. than name like yours, no sweeter name. And we come to worship you, and we come to love on you, my King. So let our praises, so let our praises fill this temple. Church, let's lift it up. Let our praise it. Let our praise it fill the temple. Let our praise it fill the temple. Let our praise it fill the temple. For you are good. Come on, just the voices. Church, let's lift it up.
Be lifted higher.
Yeah, no.
Be lifted up. Be lifted higher.
Sing the next song. Can you all just repeat this after me? Say, nothing
is impossible.
Or say it like you mean it. Say, nothing
is impossible.
Do we believe that? So, come on, let's sing this.
Gonna live by what I
makes me happy. Jehovah Jireh. If you're looking for healing, just know that He's Jehovah Rapha. If you're looking for peace, know that He's Jehovah Shalom, Lord. If you ever feel alone, know that He is Emmanuel. He is with us. Come on, can we all just sing life into our own lives? If you need healing, sing unto His name. Sing, Jesus, You are Jehovah Rapha. This is my prayer.
so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. 'Cause you've been so, so kind to me. Never ending rest. It's overwhelming. It's never ending.
Action. And when God said He loved us, He didn't just say it, but he actually meant it. And the biggest expression is that of the cross. You know, church, He didn't have to come for us. He would be perfectly just letting us rot in hell. Oh, but His love. That amazing, amazing love. The love that chases us. That chases us till we're found. That leaves the 99. John Stott once said of the cross that it was our sins that put Him there. But it was His love that took Him there. That's what the cross is, church. It's God's love for us. Sometimes we get so caught up in theology that we forget about the very basics of that amazing, amazing, sweet cross. Come on, church, how many of us are thankful for that cross? Are thankful for that He came and died for us when He didn't have to? Can we just thank Him for that amazing cross? Oh God, we thank You, God, that even if I was the only person, You would still come for me, God. Oh God, we thank You, God, that Your love is never ending, that it's so overwhelming, God. And for those who have never experienced that love, just know that you cannot earn it. It's a love that's limitless. And for us who are Christians, can we go back to our first love? So God, we thank You, God, for that amazing cross. That You died for me, God. Oh, what amazing love, God. That amazing love. That You thought of me worthy, God. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whomever shall believe in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And this is the love of God. Not that we first loved Him, but that He first loved us. For while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Come on, church, how many of us are just thankful for that cross, that amazing cross? Can we lift our hands and just thank Him for that amazing cross, God? Oh, we thank You, God. We thank You, God, now. It's overwhelming. It's never ending. And that is Your love. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down faster. I don't deserve.
deserve it, still you give yourself away.
Faithfulness, your faithfulness.
Next to you and just prophesy with them and say, God, that you would do it again.
Yes.
Like you always do, God, like you always do.
Yes, do, Lord, you do, Jesus.
To prophesy and say, God, that you would do it again.
Presence, I want you to just take a moment, please, and just to remember, to recount what God has done in your past, His goodness, His faithfulness to you, and just say, God, I believe I'll see you do it again. You've been faithful to me in the past. You've brought me through situations. You've helped me overcome. You've helped me triumph. You have given me your favor. You've opened doors for me. And God, I believe I'll see you do it again. I'll see you do it again. Father, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your goodness in our lives. That you are faithful, Father. You're faithful to us.